Take a listen. Does that sound familiar? Today we proudly strum our way through this CCR classic. I'm Irene. Let's get rolling. Now this is a late 60s rock and roll classic song. Rolling on the River. Actually, a lot of people think it's that, but it's called Proud Mary. And it was a song made famous by CCR, Creedence Clearwater Revival. John Fogerty wrote it. Once upon a time, John Fogerty actually got sued by his former record company for sounding too much like himself. I kid you not. If you want to find out more about it, Google it. Anyway, I'm going to talk first about the chords in Proud Mary. So the chords we're doing are a C, an A, G, F, and then a D for most of the song, and an occasional B minor. So the two chords you're going to struggle most with as a beginner are probably going to be F and B minor. So you might want to work on those a little bit just before you get into the body of this song. Anyway, assuming that you know what the chords are, we're going to talk first about the strumming pattern. If you'll see below on the screen here is all written out in arrows, and that's really just showing you the down up motion of my strumming. So if you look right at the beginning, you'll see that there's a 4/4, 4/4. Actually, that is what is called the time signature. If you know all about time signatures, you can ignore the rest of this, and I won't go into too much detail, but essentially 4/4 is the count of the song, and it's the most common count of music, which is why it's called common time. So what it means, basically, very simply, is that we count to 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, when we start the song. So that's what the 4/4 refers to. The next part you'll see is the down-up motion of the strum pattern. Before we actually play the chords, what we're going to do is work on the strum. One thing you'll notice is that some of them are grayed out. So that's what I call a ghost strum. A ghost strum is when you move the hand, but you don't actually hit the strings. So if I'm doing this strum pattern, the down, up, down, up. So the first part of it is strummed, up, and then we go down, up, down, up. So two of the strums are grayed out because of that, because they're ghost strums. So let's practice, let's slow it way down and just practice the strum with no chords. So I'm going to count in very slowly, and you always have to start slow. The other option you have is to pause this video and just practice it after we do it, just to do it a few times until you kind of get it. So if I count us in very slowly, 1, 2, 3, 4, down, up, down, up, up, down. That's the strum. So we're going to do it again a couple of times. 2, 3, 4, down, up, down, up, up, down. Good. Now, what actually happens is we do that strum twice. So let's see if we can do it two times in a row. And again, if you need to, just pause the video and practice it on your own for a bit. So we're going to do it two times this time. 2, 3, 4, down, up, down, up, up, down. Once you've mastered that, then you can add the chords. The first chord is a C, and we're going to change to an A partway through the strum pattern. So if you're used to playing chords just regularly, you might be used to changing just at the beginning of a bar or measure, but in this case we're doing it partway through. So what happens, it starts with the C for the first three strums, I think. Down, up, down. And then we switch to the A on an upstroke. Now that's the other thing that's a bit of a challenge. You're used to probably changing chords on a downstroke. This is on an upstroke. But we're going to try to do it very slowly, and then we'll see how it goes. Three, four, down, down, and then A, up, down. Let's do that again a couple of times, very slowly. Two, three, and four, and down, down, up, up, down. We'll do it again, back to C, down, down, that. So that's the very beginning of it, the part that you probably recognize more than anything else. But the third measure is a little different. It starts out the same, down, up, down, then it goes up for A and up for G and then up for F. So that's a bit of a challenge. You might want to try going from the A, G, like that a little bit. Just work on that part, just getting used to those changes. So let's do that whole measure, starting again with the C, two and three and four and down. Do that one more time. Again, pause the video if you need to practice it. Three and four and down, down, A, G, F. Okay, so if you can get that far, the last measure you'll notice that it says 3/4. That's because the count in that measure is 3 instead of 4. So we count 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. But that might complicate things in your ear, so we're not going to worry too much about counting ourselves into this measure. You are still on an F at this point. It's going to sound like this. That's right. So we started on F at the end of the measure before, and then we stay on that F until we get into the song. So if I put that together with the third measure, it'll sound like this. Right. So practice that third measure a few times through. After that, we get into a D. And that's just a regular strum. So a regular strum could be 2 and 3 and 4 and 1, which is what I call my regular strum, but everybody has their own way of playing it. So what I'm going to do lastly is I'm going to play through the whole thing very slowly, just so you have something to play along with. Okay? So I'm counting us in. 2, 3, 4. Is the intro. Now, when you're first learning it, you have to be a little bit patient with yourself. There's a lot of changes in weird places, and the chord strum isn't a regular strum. But if you slow it down at first, it's more difficult to play slowly, but it's actually worth the effort. Playing it more slowly will eventually get kind of in your head and your hands where you're supposed to be and when, and then you can start picking up the pace until you can play it. Also shows up a couple of times in the song, so I hope this helped you on your guitar playing journey. Let me know if you have any comments, and please like and share this video. And you can really help out if you subscribe, then you'll know what videos are most recent. Thanks, and keep on playing.